welcome back or welcome to my channel. In today's video, we're going to talk about something that I've been doing for a little while now, and that's the monthly reset. If you're not familiar with what that is, it's basically a way to start fresh every month and set new goals for yourself. So let's get started. This month's theme is planning and preparation. The first thing you want to do is take a look at your goals from the previous month. But before we really even get into the reset, I want to show you guys how I actually get started. So the first thing I like to do is actually get myself ready for the day, even if I'm just going to be doing admin work at home. I usually either sit in a quiet place in my home or somewhere quiet just to kind of chill and relax so I can get that clear head. Now I know sometimes when we work at home, we want to be a little bit lazy, stay in our pajamas or, you know, bummy clothes if you would say, but really taking that step to getting yourself ready like you're going out somewhere, even if you are staying at home, makes you kind of feel better when you're actually planning and doing the stuff that you need to do. So when you, like I always say, when you look good, you feel good, when you have a clear, clean space, clear head, you're gonna do better and you can focus and think more. So that's something that I really noticed really does help me when I take that extra step, and it's kind of something to get into a good habit, of course, to do. I always say get ready for the day because spur of the moment, you might want to go somewhere and then you'll already be ready. And I had a meeting today, and today's meeting location happened to be Starbucks.
Thank you.
So this is why I say always try to look your best when you go out. You never know who you're gonna see, who you're gonna run into. And then of course, an added compliment will boost your mood and help you for the day. Now back to the planning. So sometimes I would usually treat myself to Starbucks or Panera and then just sit inside to kind of do some planning. But today I actually had a business meeting to start planning some upcoming events that I'm gonna be attending this year. And also I just wanted to add those dates to the calendar so I can fully prepare month by month. It's also a good time to set new goals for the month ahead and make sure that they're specific and measurable and achievable. This is something that I do in the meetings when I have them. So I have several projects and ideas that I want to release this year. So I had to break them down into weekly assignments just to get them ready for my release dates. Now, this is something that I find harder to do when you work for yourself. And this isn't knocking any other job, if you would say a 9-to-5 job, but you have to hold yourself more accountable to actually get things done because no one's going to be there looking over your shoulder or going to give you deadlines and make you do those assignments. For example, instead of saying I want to grow my channel, I say I want to gain 100 new subscribers this month. And then I can even go farther by saying by posting more engaging and higher quality content to gain those subscribers. So this way you'll have a clear idea of what you're working towards and also have a plan of action. It's also important to take some time to declutter and organize your space. This could be your physical space, like your desk or closet, or even your digital space, so like your computer or phone. So getting rid of things that no longer serve you and just organizing what's left so you can feel more focused and productive. For me, like I said, having that clean workspace helps me be able to basically think. When your space is kind of cluttered, you kind of can't concentrate as much. I'm more so speaking for myself, and some of you may have felt like this as well. Now, my space isn't usually as bad, but once in a while I have to go in with this deep cleaning. I usually clean it pretty much every day, but sometimes when I'm working on long projects like editing videos and things like that, I have several drinks. You can see my coffee warmer, everything. So I just had to kind of dust around the whole area, basically get it nice and clean and neat. Like I said, I do this often, but sometimes every once in a while you need to do a deep cleaning on your area to make sure it's nice and fresh. And of course, lighting the candle, getting my scents together, having the sprayer or candle always makes it feel fresh and I feel refreshed. One thing I love to do is actually go to the gym to help de-stress, especially after a meeting to help clear your mind. You don't always have to go to the gym. You can do anything active just to have fun and boost your mood for the day. So a major goal of mine was to get healthy, and I broke that down into proper nutrition and to lose weight. So I've also been meal prepping and juicing. So far I lost about 5 pounds. With me being more specific and saying I want to lose weight and eat good food, I decided to go to the gym or work out at home a certain amount of times and do specific exercises that will help me. And also preparing those meals in advance did help me, and it helped me heal my gut and reduce my body fat at the same time. On days that I don't have meetings or anything planned, I like to plan out my goals and do my reflections at home. So I like to make me a little snack and a coffee and then have a nice chill setting for myself. So once I get comfortable in my setting, I have to put on some music. Music is something that I always have to have because it blocks out distractions and it keeps me focused. So I also did make a few songs myself if you guys want to listen. I'll link in my Spotify and my Apple Music artist page. I normally play instrumentals or some kind of street noise, lo-fi, however you say that, and like an ambient to eliminate noise. That just helps me block out distractions, like I said, and I do create some of those myself, so you guys can check that out as well. But now that I'm nice and focused, I can start reflecting on my tasks and goals that I want to achieve for this month. Now, when setting new goals, I like to reflect on the old ones and basically build off of those, because if some of them I didn't get done, that's okay. I can kind of put them in for this month and then I can tweak them to make sure that I actually do get them done. So I like to go through a series of questions for one to ask myself, did I achieve them? If not, why not? Then I take some time to reflect on what went wrong and what I can do differently for this month to actually achieve those goals. Once you've officially set your goals, it's time to create a plan of action. Now, I like to break down my goals into smaller tasks that I can work on and not only do weekly, but even to each day. Now, this makes them feel more manageable and it can help me stay on track. So it's also important to track your progress throughout the month as it is to plan it. This will help you stay motivated and see how far you've actually come. So you can use a planner, a journal, or an app to track your progress. You see, I use a big calendar and the little journal I have, as well as an online planner, which I use Trello, if you guys might want to check that out. I do that for actually planning my videos and then certain drops that I have for within the month. But there you have it. These are my tips for a successful month goal reset. Remember, setting goals is important, but it's also important to break them down in a smaller task and track your progress. Now, this is something that I've been doing as I keep my big calendar to the right of me as a glance, so I can add into my small planner for the weekly deadlines and daily tasks to complete. I can always see them right there, and it's not hard for me to add them into my daily tasks. So remember, it's never too late to start fresh and set new goals for yourself. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.